everybody. It's me, Ann Krajewski. It's another day in paradise here at the Quiet Asylum, beautiful downtown Ithaca, New York. Today, we are working on the victor of the election. Nice for the liberals, nice for the Dems, not so much for the Republicans. But hey, we're all in this together, so we're working together. So, let's go to the leader of the free world. A man who needs no introduction, basically. Of course, I have roughed this out for you. And we just start filling in eyebrows. Why did I choose this shot? The man has got an amazing smile, seriously. Both he and Michelle have great teeth. Wish I had good teeth. Radiation underground and in the sky. Animals and birds who live nearby are the night. Mercy, mercy, mercy. All things and what they. Oh, I want to apologize to you guys. On my last show with Holly Adams, I messed up the intro to one of my 21 Boxes artists, and I'll fix that. But anyway, I'm very sorry to Ryan B. Curtis. He was not the 21 Boxes artist video. And for those of you who watch the show on a regular basis, the music that I'm playing, of course, you hear Marvin Gaye in the background, provided by Bullseye Radio, of course, is the same music that I chose for my Savante Myrick show. And, well, I just thought leaders, I thought it was appropriate to the theme. So. Plus, the music just kicks ass anyway. Also, I'm trying on some new training wheels, people, here, meaning my paper. And it's kind of groovy, actually. I kind of like this stuff. Looks like the pencil slides pretty smoothly, and it's got a good beat, and you can dance to it. Sorry. To do that. You know what they say, people. Everybody wants to rule the world. Yes, they do. Actually, I'm liking this paper a whole lot. You know, I feel bad that I didn't even watch the inauguration. I mean, this is terrible. I expected to, and then, I don't know, something happened. You know, it's not so much the inauguration. I really don't give a crap whether Beyonce lip-synced or not. I wanted to see Michelle's dress and the new haircut. Speaking of which, I think I'm going to use Michelle as my inspiration and go get a new do. I think it's time. I know my beloved thinks it's probably a good idea. I mean, look at this hair. This is like totally uncontrollable. don't want to waste time sitting there. I knew this was gonna have to have a little eraser action. Put that. Would this be an incisor? Don't know. Oh, gosh, you guys, you know, it's kind of fun to do this. Like I said, I haven't used this paper before. It's a first, but I want to tell you guys to email me. So, to that end, follow my bouncing paws, okay? Animation78@live.com. You know, I love hearing from you. And back to Barack Obama. So, okay. We'll do a little shadowing. Ah, and we have lemonade. That's the name of the group. I think the song is Cool Water. Boy, being the presidency, you ever notice what it does to people? I mean, how can you miss it? I mean, Barack's first, Mr. President's first inauguration, you know, he looked young, he looked hip, you know, he was with it. But like every other person who's in the presidency, God, does it age you or what? Oh, don't get me wrong, he's still adorable. But, you know. Man, that job's gotta just... did not like where I placed his ears before. So I'm gonna go right over it. Now remember, kids, this is not an art lesson. This is art otainment. You know what? I think, people, that maybe we should go to a little home video action. So, take it away, Lauren.
Can't do with the mouse. What are you gonna do with the mouse? Where's the mouse? Where's the mouse? Where's the mouse? Oh, 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 gracious.
And we're back. We are back with Barack Obama, or trying to be. And we're also back with Jess Jack, Stars in Her Eyes, one of my favorite little disco ditties.
They'll be making sure you stay amused. They'll fill you up with drugs and booze. Maybe you'll make the evening news. And when you're tripping over your dreams, they'll keep you down by any means. By the end of the night, you'll be stifling your screams. Since you became a VR person, it's like your problems have all worsened. Your paranoia casts aspersions on the truths, you know. And they'll just put you in a spotlight and hope that you'll do alright.
Or maybe not. So why do you want to put stars in your eyes? Why do you want to put stars in your eyes?
So why do you want to go and put stars in your eyes?
Can you hear me do that whisper?
Why do you want to go and put stars in your eyes? Stars in their eyes. Remember they said you'd show them all, emphasize the rise but not the fall, and now you're playing a shopping mall. Your mum and dad, they can't believe what you appear to have achieved, while the rest of these users are just laughing in their sleeves. And since you became a VR person, it's like your problems have all worsened. Your paranoia casts aspersions on the truths, you know. And now the tabloids use your face to document your fall from grace. And then they'll tell you that that's just the way it goes. That's just the way it goes. Now why'd you wanna go and put stars in their eyes? It's the same old story, well they just didn't realize. And it's a long way to come from the dog and duck karaoke machine and Saturday night's drunken dreams. Now why'd you wanna go and put stars in their eyes? It's the same old story, well they just didn't realize. And it's a long way to come from your private bedroom.
So, you know, recently I was on the Bullseye chat room at BullseyeRadio.com. The guy who provides my music, John Michael, was very nice to me talking about Quiet Asylum on the air. It was really nice, and I really appreciate it. I'm using my eraser to actually blend. You like that. But only for a little bit. Oh, now just Jack is going to go into his rap thing.
Behind a steel barrier, sequins and glitter. 5-inch heels still knee deep in the litter. Each of them a bit of all shitter. Wrapped up in the cloak of fake glamour, getting lost in the clamour. With footprints of fool's gold. And diamonds cross the grips on their one-off plimsolls. So little time for these one-off arseholes. Rigor mortis, Ken and Barbie dolls. A pair of big shades and a push-up bra. It's such a short gap between the guts.
Did they just say push-up bra? Interesting.
So why do you want to go and get so downhearted? Welcome to the kingdom of the blagger. Uncutting your nose, decoding. in your bladder. A whole lot happier, a whole lot sadder. Used to be satisfied, now you feel like Mick Jagger.
Mick Jagger. I like to use this song under pressure. I figure, you know, that's very fitting for, you know, well, the president. You know, it's not like he has any pressure at all, right? Drawing the teeth in. Normally I'd be using a blender, but since I don't see one here today, I guess, well, I'll have to be done without it. That's okay. We deal with that. Okay. Sing it, Freddie. Sing it, David. And while I'm messing around with this, oh my God, these ears, hello! While I'm messing around with these ears, I think it's time for us to go to another home video. So, take it away, Lauren!
This is Arnold's Oscar moment. I don't think so.
like the cold zone.
And we're back. We are back with a joyful Barack Obama. And we're also on with the Groove Line. Everybody get funky. Little laugh dance for you. Yeah, that's better. Fix those eyebrows, honey. Eyebrows are very, very important in a portrait. Especially when you have eyebrows, well, like Mr. President here. And for those of you who have not been watching Quiet Asylum for a very long time, I did a picture of Michelle Obama in 2009. It was one of my first shows. And that really was a groovy show. I didn't want his neck floating in the air, if you know what I mean. We're back on the Groove Line. Back on that Groove Line. I still don't like this eyebrow. But, you know, sometimes you just can't win them all, you know what I mean? Coming up very soon, I will be having a very, very special guest. Some very special guests, actually. I have Brian Van Campen, the fabulous host of the Sheldon the Sheep Show here on Pegasus. And I will be having Darcy Martin, fabulous actress. And she and I are going to have a really nice chat. I can't wait for that. And of course, sometimes it'll just be you, me, and the fence post here at Pegasus Studios. At this point, I think we are wrapping the show up. While I do this, I love this song. New Radicals, you get what you give. Get ready. This is a song of optimism, so I hope you guys are optimistic about what the future holds for our country. I know I am. I know I am in a super good place in my life right now. I hope you guys are too. Yeah. Give it to me now. My fingers hung up. But anyway, I gotta go, people. I've loved having you. And remember, I'm Ann Krajewski, and maturity is an overrated virtue. So I'll see you guys later. Everybody, it's me, Ann Krajewski. It's another day in paradise here at the Quiet Asylum, beautiful downtown Ithaca, New York. Today, we are working on the victor of the election. Nice for the liberals, nice for the Dems, not so much for the Republicans. But hey, we're all in this together, so we're working together. So, let's go to the leader of the free world. A man who needs no introduction, basically. Of course, I have roughed this out for you. And we just start filling in eyebrows. Why did I choose this shot? The man has got an amazing smile, seriously. Both he and Michelle have great teeth. Wish I had good teeth. Radiation underground and in the sky. Animals and birds who live nearby are alive. Oh, mercy, mercy me. All things and what they do. Oh, I want to apologize to you guys. On my last show with Holly Adams, I messed up the intro to one of my 21 Boxes artists, and I'll I'll fix that. But anyway, I'm very sorry to Ryan B. Curtis. He was not the 21 Boxes artist video. And for those of you who watch the show on a regular basis, the music that I'm playing, of course, you're hearing Marvin Gaye in the background, provided by Bullseye Radio, of course. It's the same music that I chose for my Savante Myrick show. And, well, I just thought Leaders, I thought it was appropriate to the theme. So, plus the music just kicks ass anyway. Also, I'm trying on some new training wheels, people, here, meaning my paper. And it's kind of groovy, actually. I kind of like this stuff. Looks like the pencil slides pretty smoothly, and it's got a good beat, and you can dance to it. To do that. Da, 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 dun. Ah. You know what they say, people? Everybody wants to rule the world. Yes, they do. Actually, I'm liking this paper a whole lot. You know, I feel bad that I didn't even watch the inauguration. I mean, this is terrible. I expected to, and then, I don't know, something happened. You know, it's not so much the inauguration. I really don't give a crap whether Beyonce lip-synced or not. I wanted to see Michelle's dress and the new haircut. Speaking of which, I think I'm going to use Michelle as my inspiration and go get a new do. I think it's time. I know my beloved thinks it's probably a good idea. I mean, look at this hair. This is like totally uncontrollable. I'm sitting there. I knew this was going to have a little eraser action. Like that. Would this be an incisor? Don't know. We'll be right back. Oh, gosh, you guys, you know, it's kind of fun to do this. Like I said, I haven't used this paper before. It's a first. But I want to tell you guys to email me. So, to that end, follow my bouncing paws, okay? Animation78@live.com. You know I love hearing from you. And back to Barack Obama. So, okay. We'll do a little shadowing. Ah, and we have lemonade. That's the name of the group. I think the song is Cool Water. Boy, being the presidency, you ever notice what it does to people? I mean, how can you miss it? I mean, Barack's first, Mr. President's first inauguration, you know, he looked young, he looked hip, you know, he stuck with it. But like every other person who's in the presidency, God, does it age you or what? Oh, don't get me wrong, he's still adorable. But, you know. Man, that job's gotta just... Did not like where I placed his ears before. So I'm gonna go right over it. Now remember, kids, this is not an art lesson. This is art entertainment. you know what? I think, people, that maybe we should go to a little home video action. So, take it away, Lauren.
Can't do it with the mouse. What are you gonna do with the mouse? Where's the mouse? Where's the mouse? Where's the mouse? Oh, 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 gracious.
And we're back. We are back with Barack Obama, or trying to be. And we're also back with Jess Jack, Stars in Her Eyes, one of my favorite little disco ditties.
They'll be making sure you stay amused. They'll fill you up with drugs and booze. Maybe you'll make the evening news. And when you're tripping over your dreams, they'll keep you down by any means. By the end of the night, you'll be stifling your screams. And since you became a VR person, it's like your problems have all worsened. Your paranoia casts aspersions on the truths, you know. And they'll just put you in a spotlight and hope that you'll do all right.
Or maybe not. So why do you want to put stars in your eyes? Why do you want to put stars in your eyes?
So why do you want to go and put stars in your eyes?
You hear me do that whisper?
Why do you want to go and put stars in your eyes? Stars in your eyes. Remember they said you'd show them all, emphasize the rise but not the fall. And now you're playing a shopping mall. Your mum and dad, they can't believe what you appear to have achieved. While the rest of these users are just laughing in their sleeves. And since you became a VR person, it's like your problems have all worsened. Your paranoia casts aspersions on the truths, you know. And now the tabloids use your face to document your fall from grace. And then they'll tell you that that's just the way it goes. That's just the way it goes. Why'd you wanna go and put stars in their eyes? It's the same old story, well they just didn't realize. And it's a long way to come from the dog and duck karaoke machine and Saturday night's drunken dreams. Now why'd you wanna go and put stars in their eyes? It's the same old story, well they just didn't realize. And it's a long way to come from your private bedroom.
So, you know, recently I was on the Bullseye chat room. BullseyeRadio.com. The guy who provides my music, John Michael, was very nice to me talking about Quiet Asylum on the air. It was really nice and I really appreciate it. I'm using my eraser to actually blend. You like that. But only for a little bit. Oh, now just Jack is going to go into his rap thing.
Behind a steel barrier, sequins and glitter. 5-inch heels still knee deep in the litter. Each of them a bitter bullshitter. Wrapped up in the cloak of fake glamour. Getting lost in the clamour. With footprints of fool's gold. And diamonds cross the grips on their one-off plimsolls. So little time for these one-off arseholes. Rigor mortis, Ken and Barbie dolls. A pair of big shades and a push-up bra. It's such a short gap between the gut.
Did they just say push-up bra? Interesting.
So why'd you want to go and get so downhearted? Welcome to the kingdom of the blagger. Uncut in your nose, Clico. In your bladder, a whole lot happier, a whole lot sadder. Used to be satisfied, now you feel like Mick Jagger.
Mick Jagger, Mick Jagger, Mick Jagger.
We'll be right back.
I like to use this song under pressure. I figure, you know, that's very fitting for, you know, well, the president. You know, it's not like he has any pressure at all, right? Drawing the teeth in. Normally I'd be using a blender, but since I don't see one here today, I guess, well, I'll have to be done without it. That's okay. We deal with that. Okay. Sing it, Freddie. Sing it, David. And while I'm messing around with this, oh my God, these ears, hello! While I'm messing around with these ears, I think it's time for us to go to another home video. So, take it away, Lauren!
This is Arnold's Oscar moment.
Hello, Arnold. Thanks, Paul.
All right, Freezy, you can't live outside the cold zone.
And we're back. We are back with a joyful Barack Obama. And we're also on with the Groove Line. Everybody get funky.
Come
little laugh dance for you. Yeah, that's better. Fix those eyebrows, honey. Eyebrows are very, very important on a portrait. Especially when you have eyebrows, well, like Mr. President here. And for those of you who have not been watching Quiet Asylum for a very long time, I did a picture of Michelle Obama in 2009. It was one of my first shows. And that really was a groovy show. Wanting his neck floating in the air, if you know what I mean. We're back on the groove line. Groove line. I still don't like this eyebrow. But, you know, sometimes you just can't win them all. You know what I mean? Coming up very soon, I will be having a very, very special guest. Some very special guests, actually. I have Brian Van Campen, the fabulous host of the Sheldon the Sheep Show here on Pegasus. And I will be having Darcy Martin, fabulous actress. And she and I are going to have a really nice chat. I can't wait for that. And of course, sometimes it'll just be you, me, and the fence post here at Pegasus Studios. We are wrapping the show up. While I do this. Ah, I love this song. New Radicals, you get what you give. Get ready. This is a song of optimism, so I hope you guys are optimistic about what the future holds for our country. I know I am. I know I am in a super good place in my life right now. I hope you guys are too. Give it to me now. My fingers hot enough. But anyway, I gotta go, people. I've loved having you. And remember, I'm Ann Krajewski, and maturity is an overrated virtue. So I'll see you guys later.